yo, Ricky, what's up, man?
Yo, what up, MP?
Hey, yo, look, good looks on the internet today, bro.
Yeah.
You trying to play 2K or something?
Nah, man, I'm checking out the analytics on your page right now.
Hey, that's why you the manager, bro, always getting it done.
You do know managers get paid, right? I'm more like your mom right now.
Oh, no, negative, bro. My mom, she know how to cook.
Oh, well, all of a sudden you don't like ramen?
For breakfast? Every day?
Nah. Yo, you know we getting a lot of comments on this video we just uploaded, right?
Hold on, let me go find it. 1, 2, 3. Hey, yo, look, 6'6", trash talker, exposed, bro. I told y'all he was garbage, man. He ain't never played no organized ball.
Yeah, maybe, but then I talk about how you hit that filthy step back in his eye.
What they talking about?
They're all asking what you about to do next, man. Look, why hasn't MP signed with a college yet? Told y'all he's trash. MP scared a real comp or something? Can't stay an influencer forever, son. Like, they just keep going.
Man, let them ask. Look, let the intrigue build, bro. We just got here 3 days ago, Rick. Can I get settled in before I have to make some major life decision?
Leagues run on schedules, bro. It's nice that we're making enough money to pay your rent off your socials,
yeah,
but...
Yeah, barely.
But college ball's not gonna wait on MP, the influencer, to just make up his mind before they start the season. Look, you're not bigger than the sport of basketball, bro.
Thank you. Captain Obvious. Thank you, Rick.
Well, I'd rather be Captain Obvious than Captain Oblivious.
Look, man, I barely even know where the best spots are, all right? How are we supposed to have this music and fashion empire if we're not even in the local scene?
By doing exactly what we've talked about since I convinced you to start making videos in the 8th grade. Establishing yourself as a basketball star. Everything comes off of that. Like, no one wants to start a fashion line with the 15th man on the team.
Hey, look, I'm just messing with you, Rick. Chill out.
Okay, ha, ha, ha. You're so funny. What, you want to add comedian to the list, too?
Bro, no one's trying to be funny. All I'm saying is I just need time to process it.
We don't have time, MP. Unless you want to be a street ball player for the rest of your life, you need to make a decision, and you got to make it soon.
It's tough.
Okay, let's go over my options again.
Great. All right, so obviously the goal is the NBA, but the question is, how do we get there? Now, we could declare for the draft right now and take our chances.
Get drafted as an afterthought in the 2nd round, or not at all, ruin my career.
Doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I'm not into none of that, Rick.
Okay, well then we could do college or G League.
Right.
Okay, since you're still hesitant, maybe you need a new perspective. Lucky for you, I got a couple guys lined up that might be able to talk both options with you.
Hey, look at you, Mr. Manager. Way to leverage those connects, bro.
You act like I ain't been networking since kindergarten.
True.
Look, anyway, I got you a meeting with Che.
Play for Porter Che?
Mm-hmm.
You know him, bro?
Nah, he knows you. He's a fan of the channel. I hit him up on socials, he responded immediately.
Yo, that's what's up, bro.
Look, he said he'd love to talk with you about college. I mean, obviously with him being a 4-year guy who went through a lot, he knows better than most.
Yo, word. Yeah.
Yeah, I also got you a meeting with AI to talk about G League.
Allen Iverson.
Wait.
Allen Iverson. No. You got me a meeting with AI, bro? That's some name?
No.
What's up?
The other AI.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. You know, I get that too. Yeah. Look, I saw he was playing for the team Ignite now. I guess he into that whole mentor thing, huh?
Yeah. He's really done a lot of growing up over the years.
You know what, man? I appreciate you taking the time to set this all up, bro. That's nice of you, bro.
Look. I'm not gonna make no money as your manager if you're selling unlocked cell phones out the back of a barbershop, you know?
Heartwarming.
Look, you know, if you wanna get a little run in while you think it over, you should hit up some of the courts around the city. I mean, they got some great ballers out there. Good pickup games.
Hey, look, I'm gonna check that out, bro. But for real, I appreciate you putting all this together for me, bro. That's major, fam.
Like I said, man, I can't have you flipping burgers.
I like burgers, though, bro. You know the ones
no,
with the cheese,
stop.
The bacon.
Go. Go talk to Chad, go talk to AI, get your mind right, and then come back and we can talk business.
So you don't want no burger?
No, just go.
I'm leaving.
What's up? Get in here.
It's a dude now.
Get out of here.
Hey, have a look around.
Afternoon. Can I help you find something special? Have a wonderful day. Hey, welcome in. Let me know if you need any help. See you around.
Hi, let me know if I can help.
Hey, good to see you. Welcome in.
Please, shoot.
Welcome in. Bye, see you again soon.
Hey, good to see you.
They really put State Farm in the game. That's crazy.
Thanks for stopping. Have a nice day. Hey, when you come to your
job, it's your trouble. Come on in, have a good time. Don't be a stranger now.
Welcome. Take a look around.
Uh-oh. Oh, that is tough, bro. I'm gonna customize now.
Have a good one.
Welcome, come on in. See you later.
the new feature called Seasons. Enjoy new theme challenges, music, and clothing drops, even new modes popping up as you play through the year.
Take a look around. Have a good one.
Welcome in.
Bye, see you again soon.
Hey, good to see you. Welcome in.
Take your shirt off. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Hey, what's up? Get in here.
Look at all this stuff.
Get out of here.
Welcome in. Let me know if you need any help. See you around.
Good to see you. Thanks for staying. Have a nice day.
Hey, neighbor.
Are you?
Jake from State Farm.
Oh, you hang out here, bro?
Yeah, hey, right next to the course in your neighborhood.
Hey, that's dope, fam.
Hey, speaking of being a good neighbor, I'd like to welcome you to the city. Very excited to have the great MP as my newest neighbor.
Hey, look, I appreciate that, man. I didn't realize you was a fan, homie.
Oh, hey, we're all rooting for you, MP.
It's good to know.
Yeah. Hey, as a show of my support, I'd like to offer you my official look. Can't join Team State Farm without the drip, right?
Hey, look, I guess not, bro.
Hey, awesome. I'll be seeing you around, MP. Let me know if you need anything. And remember, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Yeah, I was waiting for you to say that. Hey, look, I appreciate this. Jake from State Farm.
Yeah, hey, listen, pleasure's all mine. Keep doing your thing.
And bro should get in my store for free.
Offense wins games, but defense wins championships. It's a cliche, but it's true. If you can lock up some shooters in the park today, there'll be a little something extra in it for you.
Hey, all right?
MP, what up, baby?
Nice to meet you, man. Look, I appreciate you talking to me.
Hey, no problem, bro. Your boy Ricky sent over your tape, man. I gotta say, you got a little game.
I got a little game?
Just a little bit.
I appreciate that.
You could use some work, not gonna lie, but the potential's there, man. I think the G League would be good for you.
Put me up on game. Why you think that?
All right, so check this out, man. Like, G League is different from when I was coming up.
Okay.
Like, I didn't have all my stuff together back then. It was a different road. Like, you know I'm playing for Team Ignite, right?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so...
Yeah.
So we didn't have anything like that back then. Like, it was kind of a every man for himself sort of vibe. But now, Team Ignite is basically designed to help top prospects play at a pro level. right?
Yeah.
So that's why I signed with them. Like, I want to help the next generation learn the way that I was taught by my mentors.
Hey, man, I respect that. I really do.
Yeah. Not to mention, I mean, you're already a pro, so you're free to pursue whatever opportunities that you can get, man, assuming that you can play at a level that sponsors want to look at you.
Hey, I hear you, bro. What the money look like?
Oh, it's good.
It's good?
It's good, bro.
That's dope, man. You got any regrets about that first route you took?
I mean, not really, man. Like, everything that happened to me is kind of what made me who I am. But I will say, man, it's difficult, right? Like, they expect you to play like a pro,
yeah.
Right? So you got to give it your full commitment, no exceptions. They will cut you from the roster like that.
Oof, that's intense, bro.
Yeah, it can be.
You got anything else you want to tell me?
Well, you know, G League is way different from college,
right?
Like, you got better facilities, better training, better access, and all that sort of thing. And you need to learn how to train your body like a pro, okay? So get in the gym, get your workouts in, get that muscle up, all that sort of thing. You're gonna take that knowledge with you for the rest of your career.
Hey, I'm always looking for a way to get an edge, man. That sounds good to me.
That's good, bro. Well, listen, I gotta get going, but if you got any other questions, man, feel free to reach out. Your boy Ricky knows how to contact me.
Appreciate that. Look, I appreciate you, AI. Thank you.
No problem, bro. Hey, keep working on your game, man. It's a long road ahead.
Che, right? Yo, man, I'm a big fan. I'm MP, bro.
Hey, what's good with you, Lil Wody? Nice to meet you, man.
Hey, look, thank you for taking the time to talk to me. Seriously, bro.
Oh, it's all good. I'm a big fan of your work, so happy to help any way I can. So your boy Ricky said you had some questions about college, right?
Yeah, man, look, I'm weighing a lot of options, and I think I need somebody to just help me walk through this college route, you know?
Hey, I'm a big fan of college, man.
Yeah.
I had my ups and downs, but I ended up staying all the way up to my senior year.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
But even if I left early for the league, I would still recommend it.
Why's that?
Nothing's gonna help you grow as a player like college, man. You find the right program that really knows how to nurture your gifts, you'll develop like crazy. And the whole point of college is development.
I like that. You said something about important programs, right? What you looking for there?
Well, different schools are good with different things. Some are great with big men.
Okay.
Some pump out defenders year after year, and others know how to open up your scoring. So it really depends on your gifts and, you know, your swagger and where you want to go with it.
You got any drawbacks?
Obviously, there's injury. I know you saw what happened with my guy, Porter Rose. Yeah. That was my dude. But you can get hurt tomorrow, man, playing at the park. So that really didn't factor into my decision.
Hey, look, you speaking nothing but facts, bro. Fair enough, yeah.
And nothing's like the atmosphere of college, man.
Word?
Yeah, the crowd, the campus. You're like a god there, MP.
I like that.
It's a good way to really get acclimated into the spotlight, man.
I ain't really in the shadows, though, bro. I got a million on the social.
I peep your socials, man. You got it. But look, it's a traditional route for a reason. You want to go to the NBA? You want to be a star? College is your best bet by a lot, I'm telling you.
Even after everything that you've been through, you still feel that way?
Yeah. Even after what I went through, I wouldn't change the way I handled it. And it doesn't take away from what I learned or how I developed there.
How you develop? Keep talking about development, yo. That's a word, Jay.
Yeah.
I appreciate you, bro. Seriously.
Hey, it's all good, man. Look, if you got any more questions, holler at me on the socials, all right?
I got you.
Or get my number from Ricky. Let's get some gumbo in New Orleans soon.
Hey, I got you, bro.
All right. I believe in you.
Thank you, man. We'll be right back.
If you're gonna rock the Adidas, you gotta have a little style to your game too. Do something for the highlight reels today, MP.
Okay, so what's this? Okay. What's this urgent matter you gotta talk to me about?
I never said urgent. Learn to read.
No, learn to communicate.
Learn to appreciate me.
Learn to recognize when your best friend, who clearly loves and respects you, is just giving you a hard time, bro. Chill out.
Oh, I love when you get all sentimental. You know, it's adorable.
No. I think you mean sophisticated, mature, not afraid to be vulnerable. Different things, bro.
Definitely adorable. All right, so look. I've been working on setting up this MyHub app for you. You can actually access it through the TV.
Oh, that's what you've been working on.
Yeah, look, it's a productivity app that I downloaded, right? All right, now, it's still in beta, so there might still be some bugs, but it lets you keep track of all kinds of stuff from the same screen.
Hey, good looking out, Rick.
Yeah, so anytime you got something important to attend to, it'll be on this screen. I mean, season schedules, endorsement opportunities, important social messages.
Yo, that's dope, bro. I appreciate you setting that up. That's fire.
Yeah, man. Now, you know, you'll actually have to play some real games to get endorsement opportunities and schedules, which actually brings me to my next point. You ever hear of someone named Chip Seymour?
Chip Seymour. Yeah, he's on the Flex, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think somebody had him tuned in at 98.9 at the park yesterday.
Yeah, he's like the morning drive guy, but
yeah.
Look, check this out, man.
Everyone in the city is talking about our newest resident MP. Basketball sensation and moved here to do what exactly? He hasn't declared for college. He hasn't signed with a G League team. He hasn't done anything to prove he takes his basketball career seriously since winning a few games in high school against a bunch of future pickup ballers. Now, I'm a fan of basketball, the sport, and it's played at the highest level in the NBA, not on social. So until MP starts doing something to prove he's serious about the game, I'm gonna keep on not caring about what he does. Disagree with me? Give us a call and we'll talk about it. You're listening to Chip Sable on 98.9 The Flex.
Okay, so some boomer on the radio don't get what we about. What's new, Rick?
All right, that dude is a clown, yes, but look, he's right about this, bro. Look, you gotta make a decision soon or the public perception of you is gonna shift in a way that even I'm not gonna be able to fix.
I hear you.
Always talking. All right, what's up?
All right, look, I'm ready to make a decision.
You serious? Like, you finally put your big boy pants on?
I don't like the way you said big boy pants.
Man pants.
That's somehow worse, bro.
Okay, are you ready to be the decision daddy?
Bro.
Look, you brought this on yourself, all right? You dragged this out for so long, so just spit it out. What do you want to do?
Fam, I want to go to college. Look, that's the path I always seen for myself.
I think that's the right call, man. Learn your craft, yeah. Build your draft stock, and then declare when you're ready.
Exactly.
All right, so you're 100% here. I mean, because it's not a good look to back out if you sign with a program.
Yeah, look, this is what I want.
Okay, so who's going to be lucky enough to add MP to their team this fall, huh?
Hey!
great choice.
Man, I feel good about it.
I think it's the perfect program to take your game to the next level. Look, I'm gonna send him your letter of intent and get the ball rolling.
Look, that's what's up. Yo, what we do next?
I don't know, go hit the gym or something. Look, next thing you know, the semester gonna be starting and the season will be here.
Hey, look, I'm always ready, son.
Well, that's great, my son, I'm proud of you.
How you gonna be proud of me when you my son, son?
That's weird, because I distinctly remember you being my son.
Oh, that's crazy, because that's wrong. Yeah.
After a rocky start to the season that had many doubting prize recruit NP's ability to adjust to the college game, the Texas Tech Red Raiders have come on strong down the stretch, thanks in no small part to the social sensation himself, who looked fantastic while leading his squad to a conference championship. Is this the start of something legendary for MP and company, or a blip on the radar? We'll find out more soon when the selection committee announces their always highly anticipated tournament seedings.
This is it.
Exactly.
This is it, baby.
Hey, everybody's back. It's back.
Next up, as the 8th seed in the region, we have Texas Tech.
Yes! Let's go!
Boom!
All right, everyone, listen up. First of all, congratulations! You guys did a great job getting here.
That's right.
But,
yeah, we'll get it.
Said all year, it's all about the tournament. Now, I know the 8th seed wasn't what you were hoping for going into the year, but I see a clear path forward.
Yeah.
We just won the conference tournament, and going into this thing, we are playing our best basketball of
right,
the
man.
Year.
Yep.
Now the real work begins.
Yeah, all right, guys.
Because our job is not done if we're not cutting down those nets at the end of this thing. All right?
Yeah. That's right.
Now, we got a big day of practice tomorrow, and I know you're excited, and you should be. You should be. But I need you getting some rest, okay? All right? Bring it in. Win on three. One, two, three. Win!
All right, here we go,
right.
Boys.
Yeah, hey,
boy.
MP.
Yeah, Coach, what's up?
Just want to see how you're feeling. We're going to need a lot out of you if we're going to see this thing all the way through.
Oh, look, man, I'm excited. This is what I signed up for. You know that.
I know you did. I know you did. And here we are. Now, as the 8th seed, we're going to be the underdog through a lot of this.
Okay.
Okay? So I need you 100% committed to the game plan, because every game is going to be different.
Hey, look, whatever you need, I'm not going out there to freelance. Come on.
Good. We have practice tomorrow. I need you there early.
Like I always...
No. Set a good example for the other guys.
Yeah,
okay?
I got you. Like I always...
No. Remember the time you said, I slept through my alarm, Coach.
Oh, come on, Coach. It's my fault.
No. Cannot happen again. Cannot, okay? That's all I'm saying. Every little thing matters this time of year, MP. Every little detail. Okay?
I hear you. Yeah.
All right?
Look, Coach, I'm locked in. I'm ready. We go get this WIA. I got you.
Good. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
you working on?
Is that Ray Allen I see? No, wait. It's MP!
Okay, I don't know if you're making fun of me or not.
It's like that meme. The guy that goes, not sure if serious.
Okay, Coach, that's like one of the very first memes ever made, man.
I know everything there is to know about Tribe Called Quest. You know everything there is to know about SpongeBob SquarePants. I made my choice, you made yours.
Oh, yo, I still gotta listen to that Tribe album you recommended.
Low End Theory.
Yeah.
Yeah, listen to that one for like every day for a year.
Okay, so that's like me and Future in high school. I got you. I see you, Coach.
How's your shot feeling? You locked in?
Yeah, no, I'm feeling great. Confident. Got a nice, easy ball this morning. We good to go.
Good. Because I think the kid is automatic. We're going to need you to match him shot for shot if we don't want to get sent home.
Yeah, I'm up for the challenge, Coach.
Just stay loose, all right? Count you, but remember, it's also just a game.
Like I said, I'm looking forward to the challenge.
All right. Hit the court. We'll go work some three ball. Let's go.
I actually chose my jump shot.
Way to grab that, MP! Good shot, MP! Oh! Crash, baby!
Come on. Focus. We'll get the next one. Again.
Way to snatch it, MP.
Now that we're done, get out there and put up some shots.
Thank you.
So the journey begins again. Know that stats, seeds, records are nothing.
Let's go!
I just didn't know if you down for
the you
could achieve it. Look around, it's nothing but demons. Right now, I thought you'd deceive me. So much with the
fall, I thought you'd see it coming.
This is only the beginning. A long road lies ahead. Which heroes will rise? Round one, coming up next.
And here we are, folks. Welcome. The college championship journey begins here. And with my colleagues, Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, I'm Forrest Hunt, and we're looking forward to bringing you this broadcast of college basketball on 2K Sports. We'll watch the UCLA Bruins in this one as they go up against the Texas Tech Red Raiders.
And Texas Tech, a powerhouse over the last few seasons, that's what attracted MP to the Red Raiders. But now, everything gets ramped up a notch.
And what's your read on the Bruins, Greg?
So much of their offense comes from their ability to attack you from outside. And that all starts with Wyatt Irvin. It's been a long time since we've seen a shooter of his caliber in college, and if the defense doesn't focus on him, they're going to get torched.
Tournament tipping off here for these two teams, and we'll see who will advance. Bob and Clark. Here's Carter.
Greg, as you know, there's nothing quite like the atmosphere of the tournament. I mean, it's special. It's electric. It's really unlike any other sporting event, in my opinion.
And you can feel all the eyes around the world on you. This is where legends are made and legacies are built. The winner-go-home feeling of every game cannot be replicated.
And looking at the field in the tournament this year, it feels like there are no heavy favorites to go all the way.
Even one seeds have their weaknesses. I can see 10 or more different teams making it to the finals. This thing is really wide open.
And with MP, you know he's passionate about playing hoop, but you have to wonder if his heart is set on the NBA.
He's got such a following that he could make a name for himself as a street player. Hard to do both. Not a likely outcome, but something NBA scouts need to be aware of.
And these opening round games, Clark, the 8 versus 9 matchup is always one of the fun ones.
You know, over the years, there have been some classics between the 8 and 9 seeds. Usually one of the teams is a major school that kind of got in late. Hopefully we get another great finish with this one. And MP, one of the bigger names in college, built a following with his video channel. He was famous before he even stepped foot on the campus.
MP outside. Nixon, he's guarded by Carter. Back to MP. Pass to Livingston. MP. Takes a three. Sheldon grabs the miss. And MP, with all of his internet fame, there were questions about how serious he is about high-level basketball.
Well, there's a world of difference between success on the playground and success in college basketball. MP clearly has the talent and skill. Some just wondered how it would translate to a more competitive environment.
And MP leading this team in their conference tournament. They were able to secure a ticket by winning it all. They have a lot of momentum coming into this.
Pass to Sheldon. And here's Irvin. There's the three. And he's good on the three ball. And with MP and his team, like you said, Clark, they're peaking at the right time.
And if you wonder if something clicked for them in the conference tournament, they looked a lot more focused as a team those last few games. It could be one of the dark horses in the field.
MP, he's covered by Irvin. Pass to Livingston. Nixon. And here's MP outside. And again, it's Texas Tech with the three.
MP getting fired up right now. He couldn't let that last three slide without his own answer.
Now here's Sheldon. Irvin outside. Here's Carter. Bell, he's covered by Evans. Back to Carter. Irvin on the wing. MP with the block.
MP staying engaged, locked in on defense. That's something that pro scouts are always looking for.
Pass to Nixon. Now MP. Neely with it. Kelly covering. Back to MP. Count that one.
And you look at the ascension of the Red Raiders. 2018 was really their coming out year.
They've won 27 games this regular season, earning a 3 seed. And it was the first year making the final 8 in the tournament.
Now here's Irvin. He's got 6. Bell outside. Down low. And it's going to be 2 free throws, drawing the contact on the shot. And UCLA has never had much trouble with recruiting, but lately, they...
In for your Raiders, substitution for UCLA.
Pass to Sheldon. Adams outside. It's Kelly on the wing. Fires at the elbow. The shot misses. The Red Raiders go the other way with it. Here's MP, defended by Sheldon. Screened by MP. Neely with it. MP outside. Pass to Butler. MP. Evans. He's covered by Bell. 6 to shoot from deep 3-point range. But they get it back. On the wing, MP. And out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
The Bruins will take it.
In for your Red Raiders, Stuart Livingston. Substitution.
The Bruins
for
trailing.
UCLA.
And here's Sheldon. Adams outside. Carter outside. Pass to Kelly. Sheldon. Now Adams. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And here's Livingston. MP covered by Adams. Back to MP. Pass to Evans. To the middle. And MP throws it down.
MP on the pick and roll. Scouts like to see guys who know how to play together and operate effectively in the pick and roll.
Now here's Bell. He's covered by Evans. To the inside. Here's Carter. Here's Sheldon. It's good, and he drew contact. So we're tied as we head to halftime.
That's the end of the first half. Your Red Raiders, 30.
Glad to have you with us as we get into the second half action here in the opening round on 2K Sports. And I gotta ask, what do you think about MP's performance halfway through?
I love his aggressiveness offensively. Just relentless with his attack, putting pressure on the defense.
Well, I tell you what, he is determined to make his presence felt. He wants the opposition to feel him, that killer instinct on display. They're calling his number time and time again to great effect.
And you look at the history of college basketball, there may not be a more impressive feat than UCLA's 88-game win streak and the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Yeah, tit for tat on the glass. Just one more aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game here.
Now here's MP. 10 points for him. And he gets the bucket. And you think about how that streak ended. The Irishman coming back from 11 points down with 3.5 minutes remaining.
Yeah, UCLA was trying for its third undefeated season in a row. Also lost to the Wolfpack in that year's Final Four. But then the next year, resilient, they recaptured their title.
These guys have some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
And when everyone's involved offensively, it has a way of helping you on the defensive side as well.
Pass to Bell. It's Kelly on the wing. Out of bounds. It'll go to the Red Raiders.
And I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
On offense, here are the Red Raiders. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. MP, he's covered by Irvin. Pass to Nixon. MP. Here's Livingston. That misses off the backboard.
And the Red Raiders' calling card has been their high-efficiency defense. It's an aggressive, unique scheme that baffles opponents to no end.
Now here's Irvin. He's got 13. There's a screen for the lead, and another basket for UCLA.
How about the touch inside? Irvin is known as a shooter, but they're getting it done inside.
And teams point out how quick Texas Tech is and how good they are at staying in front of people.
They rally to the ball, which often gives up open threes, but their ability to react and close out prevents those threes from being open. Makes them exhausting to play against.
Pass to Sheldon. Irvin. Now here's Carter. Shoots a three. And another three for UCLA.
And we know Irvin can shoot it. But there, beautiful read finding the open man.
Now here's MP. He's covered by Irvin. Here's Nixon. Good, and the assist goes to MP.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Pass to Sheldon. Kelly. Now here's Carter. tries from 10. Blocked. And they're able to recover. Just 5 on the clock. And the ball out of play. The Red Raiders here now. Both teams deciding to change it up.
William Berry, J.J. Allen.
Here's Texas Tech now.
We talk about programs on an upswing the last few years. Texas Tech is right at the top of that list, making the tournament 4 of the last 6 seasons.
Counting.
They're forcing the ball inside. Working beautifully.
It really is. 5 out of 6 of their last field goals have come from the paint.
Pass to Peterson. Jones. Back to Peterson. Butler pulls it in, and for the Red Raiders, recruits are starting to take notice.
They're adding 4-star prospects on the regular now, which gives them the firepower to maintain that momentum. A lot of good athletes on this team.
Here's MP. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. 2 shots coming up.
First team foul.
And for a team with so many banners hanging from the rafters, it's amazing to think that UCLA hasn't won a title since 1995.
Here's Martin. 5 points in the game. Pass to Peterson. Adams outside. Jones. He's covered by Holland. Peterson's shot is off. Texas Tech in the lead. MP outside. Right side, Rogers. And out of bounds. The Bruins will take it. So it's UCLA now. Peterson with the ball. Here's Martin. There's the screen. And stolen by MP. Here's Butler. Side Holland. Back to MP. And there is a whistle. That goes on Adams. That is his first foul of the game.
Man, that's, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
UCLA trailing. Now here's Irvin. Looking to end the drought. Goes back up. No good on the shot. Great D that time from MP. And it's the Red Raiders ball. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Pass to Butler. Back to Mills. MP outside. Outside Mills. Now MP. Sheldon with the block. And here's Bell. Outside Kelly to the paint. Sheldon. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
And really just unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
Evans outside. Screened by MP. Fires the 3. And again, it's Texas Tech with the 3.
They're getting a bunch of their points outside of the paint. 3 of their last 5 buckets are from 3-point range.
And the defense is just not closing out quick enough.
Inside, here's Irvin, and it's Wyatt Irvin with the jam.
How about Irvin with the emphatic slam? I mean, he's known as a laser on the perimeter, but showing he can take it to the cup, too.
And it's MP missing. And here's Bell from the arc, and another 3 for UCLA.
If there's a play to be made, Bell wants to make it. His will to win, unparalleled.
On the wing, MP. Back to Mills. To the middle. Here's MP. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2. It goes on Irvin.
Well, that's a nice pump fake by MP. You don't see guys use that as effectively as he did there. He drew the foul as a result.
Carter with the ball. Guarded now by Evans. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws coming forward.
And it will be offense getting right to the rim. At least they save the layup.
Old school D right there. Just telling them no easy layups. It's as simple as that. And that's what you expect from them.
Here's Evans. MP outside. Pass to Evans. Nixon. Kansas from downtown.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Now here's Kelly. They're holding on to the slimmest of leads.
And they can't afford to let it get any slimmer.
Here's Nixon. He's guarded by Carter. It's stolen by Wyatt Irvin. And the foul called on MP.
That's his fourth.
That'll get him his fourth foul of the game. Now here's Irvin. Guarded closely. A charity stripe shot. Basket made. That gives him seven field goals and 13 tries.
And hey, if you give Irvin the mid-range J, he'll take it. A dangerous shooter.
MP, covered by MP. And they're pushing it up. Here's Sheldon. And he hits it to tie the game up.
Excellent activity and timing on the offensive glass. That's how you get extra possessions.
Pass to MP. Now Evans. Back to MP. For three. Good on the three-point shot.
And MP knows the scouts love to see him range, so he's always ready to flex it.
Sheldon into the lane, and he converts the layup.
And coming down the stretch here, both teams still on fire.
Yeah, you know, the pace has only picked up the deeper we've gotten into this game, which is remarkable. It speaks to the endurance and stamina of these teams, and it's also been a lot of fun to watch.
Come on,
here's
now.
MP, plenty of space. And a little luck that time, but it drops.
And tonight has been all about MP. He's feeling it, looking like he belongs in the league.
And here's Wyatt Irvin from beyond the arc. Nails it. A tremendous three to tie it up. Livingston outside. Pass to Neely. MP outside. Evans. And here's Livingston. MP. He's covered by Irvin. Here's Neely. Back to MP. And Carter pulls it down.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Texas Tech with the ball. MP outside. Livingston. Now Kelly. Irvin outside. To take the lead. Oh, and a chance to win the game, but the last minute shot is offline. Time expires and we're going to overtime. And this is where the test comes in. Who's gonna step up and deliver? Could be anyone, but a lot of people would guess MP.
Because he exudes that it factor, you talk to anybody on his team, they'll tell you they believe in his talent. But even more than that, they believe in his competitive spirit and his will to win.
When you sit down and talk to the young man, it's really hard not to believe in him. The work he's put in, the improvement he's made, he should be a huge factor here in OT.
Irvin relishes is being the guy to take the big shot for his team. Not backing down from the spotlight one iota.
Pass to Butler. Back to MP. Here's Barry. MP, he's covered by Irvin. And once again, off the mark by Texas Tech. Bell outside. Irvin on the wing. overtime still getting started here, just about a minute in. And another basket for UCLA.
And once Urban gets going, watch out. He can heat up in a hurry and take over games.
And the Bruins making a switch here.
Justin Nixon, Derek Evans. Substitution.
Texas Tech with the ball. Trailing by four. Justin Nixon. Evans with the ball. MP on the wing. Holland. Back to MP. Screen by MP. Six on the shot clock. Evans. Back to MP. Fires from the corner. Sheldon grabs the miss.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Urban covered by MP. Here's Carter. Not enough on that one as it misses. On offense, here are the Red Raiders. 4-point game. Holland. Here's Barry. And he can't hit that time. Now UCLA takes it the other way. Pass to Urban. Sheldon, deflected, and it's out of bounds to the Bruins as UCLA retains possession. And the Red Raiders making a change here. And here's Wyatt Urban from beyond the arc. Hits the three-point bomb.
Oh, good reflexes on the catch and shoot there by Urban, showing he can score without hesitation.
MP, no good.
And I like the bold move of going right back at him to return the three, but he just couldn't get it to go. And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, not taking any chances, Greg. This is how you close a game out. Textbook.
Bell outside. And the foul called on MP. And that's his. And so the UCLA Bruins win and will move on.
And you know, getting that first win under your belt is huge. I mean, the players can finally exhale, relax a little bit, and get ready for round two.
How you doing, bro? I mean, I know you kind of been going through it ever since you flamed out spectacularly in that tournament.
You auditioning for Top Tech Daily? You need to come more provocative than that, homie.
All right, well, how about you are a disgrace to basketball. You care more about your YouTube career than you'll ever care about hooping, and you're ugly.
First of all, I'm not ugly, and just because you call yourself pretty don't mean it's true, homie.
You're right. My face makes it true.
Oh, okay.
Nah, for real, come on, you gotta just admit this. You're the athlete, and I am the brains, heart, soul, and face of this entire operation. I mean, the facts is just the facts.
Bruh, stay modest.
But for real, man, how you feeling? I mean, I know you don't really like to talk after you lose, so.
No, obviously, I didn't expect stuff to end like this, man. You know, I still got a lot of ball left in me. I'm about to sit up here and cry about it. It's whatever.
That's the only way to live life, bro.
Yeah, facts.
Hey, look, since we're on the topic, you been thinking at all about next steps? I mean, you know I always got ideas, but I want to know where your head's at right now.
Okay, how about Chris Brickley? Look, I've been thinking hard about training with him.
I mean, your draft stock is kind of on the edge right now. You could go in the second round or you could go undrafted. But a strong showing training with Brick, couple of open runs with them NBA dudes, yeah. Yeah, I mean, that could mean a lot to the right GM.
So basically, I ain't got nothing to lose. That's what you're saying.
I mean, yeah, that's basically the vibe.
Okay.
I mean, look, you can help yourself a lot, and I think that far outweighs the risk. I mean, you're already pretty under the radar right now, so it's either going to do nothing or it's going to give you a huge boost. Either way, I think it's worth a shot.
So what about the G League?
I think it's a solid option, to be honest.
But you think I should skip the draft, though?
I don't know. I mean, it's tough, man, because the position you're in right now, you could go to someone that just wants to use you as a trade ship or unexpectedly ends up with a second late in the night, and they're just like, let me take the shot, because maybe he could sell some merch.
So I can wind up in a bad situation, yeah.
Yeah, you could. Or it could be great. I mean, look at Emmanuel Quickly. Everybody thought he was going second, got drafted by the Knicks in the first, and he just took off.
Yeah, but I'm not getting drafted in the first round, bro.
Yeah, probably not.
Look, and this is why I want to go to the G League. I think that'd be the best situation for me.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, if you prove yourself there, you can get scooped up by a team at any time. Yeah, you're still a young prospect, too, so that's a lot of untapped upside there.
Yeah, I feel like I got a lot to think about, man.
Yeah, you do. But you also got a lot of people who care about you. So don't feel like you got to make this decision on your own.
Yo, for sure. I appreciate you, bro.
When you're ready to make moves, let me know.
Hey.
You made a decision, haven't you?
You can tell that just by looking at my face, bro.
Man, how long have I known you? Since what, kindergarten? And you've been making that same stupid face. So come on, tell me what you want to do.
Hey, I want to go to the G.
The G!
Hey, wait, you excited?
Yeah, man. Look, whatever you want to choose, I'm behind you 100%.
Man, you look, I just thought you was going to be upset that I didn't want to declare for the draft right now.
Man, you gotta take whatever path is right for you. And I'm always gonna support you. That'll never change. Come on, man, it's way beyond basketball.
You getting misty-eyed, bro?
Man, shut up, bro.
Hey, look, I love you, Rick!
Yeah, you say so. Hey, get out of here. I'm gonna make some calls, set some things up, and when you come back, we'll talk next steps.
That's what I'm talking about, baby!
Yo.
What's up?
How you feeling, bro? Ready to start living that professional life?
Hey, you think my mama still bring us dinner every now and then?
We're about to start living our dreams, and you still think about your mom's cooking?
Have you tasted what you be cooking in here? Yo, she making pork chops tonight. You know you love pork chops.
Honestly, no offense, but you need to get your head in the game. You need to start thinking about juggling practice and meetings, interviews.
Interviews? What do you mean interviews? I'm here to play ball. That other stuff, that's gonna have to work itself out.
Okay, but it won't just work itself out. Look, man, you and I both know you're not going to play on Ignite forever, which means you only got a little window to soak up all you can, both on and off the court.
Yeah, you're right, all right? I'm going to do whatever I got to do to be the best player that I can be, but I just need you to tell me what to do off the court, and I'm going to do it like we always did. Okay. What's different?
It's not going to work like that because we're not in high school no more, man. This is the start of, like, real life. Look, it's time that both of us figure it out what we really want to do. All right, that's going to come with some life decisions. All right, look, I can give you advice, but when it comes to making those decisions about who you want to be and who you don't want to be, only you can make that choice.
Yeah.
Look, check in with your media center more often, too. I mean, you want to talk about making decisions, that thing's going to be a lifesaver. I loaded up all the things with your daily tasks so you can figure out what you need to be doing.
Come on, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I need you for, baby. I appreciate you.
I'm just doing my job, man. Talking about my cooking.
Hey there, everybody. It's time to get going with another G League game. In this game, we'll see the Memphis Hustle against Team Ignite. Welcome, everyone. I'm Blake Suniga. Alongside me today are Brian Vanifatemi and Tim Sports. Man, it's good to be with you guys.
Always awesome to be here, Blake. Really looking forward to see how this one goes. I'm expecting both teams to really bring it tonight.
Yeah, and these guys know how important it is to play their best in these games, knowing they could be just one game away from making the NBA jump.
First look here at the former college standout MP, decided to make the move to the G League for this year.
And for his development, it makes sense. Had a good run in college and the tournament, so I'm interested to see how he fares in the G League.
Just look at what a sniper he is from long range. He's got an unusual skill set for a big man.
Early with the ball. AI's there.
Rejected by MP.
From deep. The shot, no good. Now the Hustle take it the other way. He gets it in there.
Nice focus from the big man. I like how AI absorbs whatever the D throws at him and still converts.
Now here is Barea. Back to Criapa. To end the run. Here's Jackson. Rejected by MP.
Terrific timing on the rejection. I love when MP goes after shots and erases them.
Bayless. Screen by MP. Back to Bayless. Over to the wing. Six to shoot. MP. By Jackson.
AI for three.
Off the mark. His first miss of the game. One for two. And the speed of the professional game, something incoming players always talk about.
It's not as fast as the NBA, but it's a world apart from college. It'll take some getting used to for many first-year G Leaguers.
Picks it out to MB. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. And down it goes, 2 points.
They have got to put a body on him, because otherwise, with his agility and athleticism, they're not going to be able to contain him on the offensive glass. He's just killing him.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Ignite squad. One more round of applause for your performers.
First quarter ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Barea, good.
They can't forget about him like that. He's not going to miss that open of a look.
Outside Diaz. Bayless. MP outside. AI. He's guarded by Early. Back to MP. AI outside. Shot clock at three. And here's Palmer outside. Rebound by the Hustle. And we're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. Here's Barea. The second chance effort, rejected by AI.
Don't try AI. This is his biggest strength, swatting shots, and this skill that can carry him to get a spot in the NBA.
And the big names for Team Ignite are part of the one-year program. They get compensated well as they prepare for the NBA draft.
The team serves as a professional training center for elite talent. Just another fantastic path to the NBA. He's still yet to hit a shot this quarter. He just can't get it going, and sometimes it's just not your game.
MP, no good.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt them.
Criapa for three. Erickson for three. Yes, great play by Jackson to set it up.
He caught a glimpse on the perimeter of the open man and sent the pass right over.
High post MP.
Rejected by Jackson.
He's been off his game this quarter, just hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go.
MP outside.
Back to AI.
In the dunk by AI.
This is where AI excels, running the court, using his smarts to get hoops in transitions, a real rim runner.
Now here's Criapa. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And a beautiful crossover there.
Now that's a killer crossover. The defender got totally shook up by that move.
Pass to Diaz. MP. AI. He's guarded by Early. Back to MP. And here's Palmer. MP outside.
For three.
And Palmer with the trifecta.
Yeah, you have to appreciate the unselfish attitude of MP, showing he's more than capable of finding open teammates.
Now here's Criapa. Back to Berea.
Puts up a three. Another three for Memphis.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Just trading punches from long range.
It's been a heavyweight fight.
Now that the first quarter is finished, what are your thoughts on MP's first period of play?
I love everything he's doing to protect the rim, sending a clear message at the start of this game. He seems committed to being seen as one of the G League's more formidable defenders.
No question, it must be intimidating for his opponents to get shut down like that in the early going. And look at this Ignite roster, it is special, a ton of talent jumping off the roster sheet.
They'll need to fuse it all together over the course of the season, but this is one of the most talented Team Ignite rosters we've seen. A lot can happen over the course of the year. And for many of these players, this is the first time they're getting a taste of professional ball.
And when ball is your job, as you said, Brian, you get good in a hurry. There will be a lot to learn from any first-time G-Leaguers. It's a bit of a trial by fire.
It's stolen by Berea. And they're running. Priapa for three. Happy to see that one go for his second make in 5 attempts.
If you're the guy who has to guard him, it is never going to be an easy night for you.
Pass to Bishop. Thomas. MP. Defended by Goodwin.
Here's MP. Connor grabs the miss.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get too many chances like that from short range.
Over Thomas. That one a little long.
Not pretty. Gotta just shake off a miss like that.
High post MP.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time. So we'll shoot two here.
First team foul.
And you look at how the G League is attracting top high school talent. What do you think that'll do to the college game?
It could be good in that we'll probably see fewer one-and-dones. Universities can now focus on players who might be there for a while, and that could help continuity, which is a big plus.
And MP, an immediate starter. Team Ignite felt that his talent was good enough to start right off the bat.
And with a younger team like this, talent wins out. Not a surprise to see MP starting. He'll just need to perform so his spot is justified.
And you look at Team Ignite, it's a great way to get experience and prepare for the NBA draft.
You can't overlook how paramount a professional type of environment, professional development is. You know, on this team, the prospects can eat and sleep basketball 24/7. It's the only thing on the menu. You can't get that anywhere else.
Outside for Bonner.
To the paint.
It's rebounded by Team Ignite.
Their biggest lead of the game was 9.
Back to Lawson. Pass to MP. Lawson outside.
Here's MP. And MP slams it in.
Sees an opening and does not hesitate. That shows you MP's confidence and how prepared he is.
Now Criapa.
Over MP. That shot off.
And Team Ignite going the other way now. Part of what makes the G League so exciting to follow is that it's really an ever-changing league.
Yeah, from the teams, to the players, to the rules, it's always evolving. So each season really is anyone's game.
Let's it go from deep. And Team Ignite hits again from deep.
The more touches he gets, the more the lead grows.
Pass to Knight. Looking to end the run. And that's 2 points on the layup.
Good possession resulting in the easy one down low.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. It's a pretty tight contested game here as we end the first half. Team Ignite ahead, leading by just one. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports.
And with the first half behind us, what have you seen from MP so far?
I love the dedication he's playing with on the defensive end, making the first half as hard on the opposing team as he possibly could, taking advantage of every chance he got to disrupt their offense.
Getting results like that on D has to make him an attractive G League talent. I'm excited to see if he can continue to be this much of a force on that end through the rest of the game.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
And you have to respect how quickly the Hustle found their place in the league. They finished fourth in their division in their very first season.
And that was just recently in 2017. Since then, they've made it past the first round of the playoffs and continue to find success.
And here we are, kicking off the G League season. A lot of games to be played.
Well, the traditional G League schedule, 50 games. Not as many as the NBA, but it's still a grind. For many of these players, there'll be more games than they've ever played before. Yeah, the G League hit hard by the pandemic, along with really every other league in the world, every sport. They had to cancel the end of the 2020 season. They played a shortened season in 2021 in a bubble in Orlando. Guys, this is so exciting. The start of the G League season, always fun to see new faces and talent coming into the G.
And while that's true for all teams in the G League, it's especially true for a group like Team Ignite. We could be seeing the start of not only a future NBA player, but a future franchise cornerstone tonight.
And you'd have to think it's exciting for the Hustle, being an affiliate of the Grizzlies, a young and up-and-coming team.
Absolutely. That creates a great energy for everybody involved. And, you know, all these guys are dreaming of moving up, joining the Grizz for their next playoff run.
And with the G League, they ended up with a bubble season, and that made for some intense basketball.
And I feel like that was the right choice for the G League, because teams were still able to develop their youth, and it was done in a safe and controlled environment.
Clock at six. To the middle.
Diaz, guarded by Barea.
He's still feeling it. Misses off the right iron.
Well, the shot was there for him. He had to take it. And I don't care if he didn't convert. He should take that shot every single time.
Jackson inside, covered by MP. And that one good.
I'm not sure who was supposed to be on him there. And apparently, neither did the defenders.
Pass to Diaz. Screen by MP.
AI. That's good again. His seventh basket. 7 for 10 from the floor.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. A nice job taking it right to the tin for the layup.
Outside Jackson. Pass to Erickson.
Early.
That drops, and it comes off an assist for Erickson.
Pretty passing. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Both teams deciding to change it up.
One more round of applause for your performer.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by in the second half.
Jeffrey Thomas.
Pass to MP.
Sinks the triple.
Their second half has started well. They've been good on three of their first four attempts. I like to see that.
Covered by MP.
It off the glass.
It's so nice to have someone who can take charge like he has.
They've got to be feeling good about having the ball in his hands at that end of the floor right now.
Yeah, he's just been so smooth.
Outside Palmer. Pass to MP.
For the tie. But they'll get another chance.
Palmer up top, guarded by Barea.
And they pick up two.
And MP is just taking charge right now. Every time he gets the ball, he's looking to score.
Nice D from MP. Team Ignite trailing. Lawson outside. High post MP.
Chance there to take the lead, missing. Outside Berea.
Over Lawson, rejected by MP.
For the lead. That's in there. Palmer with the assist.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five buckets are from three-point range.
The defense, they have to close out quicker.
Riapa for three. And the hustle miss again. And they can go two for one.
Most importantly, play it smart.
MP outside. The offensive rebound. Lawson. And he fakes in the layup.
Wilson found points for this team. Lawson valuing those second chance opportunities.
Now here is Berea. D right on him. And Kriyama slamming it down.
Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
I think he wants some views on that dunk.
Yeah, startling, though, that he'd even try that right now.
That play was sweet, and it was captured by our AT&T 5G Slam Cam.
To the inside. And he uses both hands to jam it in.
That's how it's done. Find that hole in the D, and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
It was. In a tight game like this one, you think that they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end, but they didn't.
And as we finish the third...
As we approach the final quarter, what do you think the focus should be for MP?
Hustle making a change here.
MP! Manuel Lawson! In for Memphis.
The hustle with the lead. Fast a good one.
2 minutes remaining in the Mendez. 2 minutes.
Outside Jackson. Inside. Rhea.
Well, the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs there.
Yeah, definitely saved the layup from that foul. He's going to have to earn him at the line.
The hustle making a switch here. And so both free throws good this time. And it's a 7-point ball game.
Good work at the line to stretch that lead out a little bit.
One more round of applause for your performers.
So it's Team Ignite now.
Palmer with it. Jackson covering. And it's good. 2 points.
Well, you're just going to have to score more than that if you're looking to stop Edwin Palmer. What a superb job he does of brushing off the contact.
The hustle making a switch here.
One more round of applause for your performers. Hustle substitution, Philip Erickson.
Erickson. If you're just tuning in, welcome. We've played about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here.
Hit the bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery into the lane.
Pass to Palmer. Back to MP. Now here's Diaz.
Screen by MP. Shot clock at 5.
Bayless. MP outside. Over early.
Again! Team Ignite.
Bill Bayless, he just got in a nice position. Set up for the catch and shoot. He trusts his mechanics.
Outside, over Bayless, and it's Kriyapa missing. And here's Team Ignite. Screen by MP. Palmer with it. Jackson covering. Back to MP. Let's go with a three.
Yes!
And he has brought them within 2 points.
He's done a lot of damage to long range guys, and there's another big one.
And it's a big one. What a performance from long range.
Now Palmer.
No time to spare. They need a bucket.
And then a steal or foul to stop the clock.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock.
Buries it from outside.
They come out of halftime smoking hot from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and as hot as they are from out there, there's absolutely no reason not to just keep letting them fly.
I agree, Brian. We should all have a green light.
So the first one drops, and that will put them up two. And so he drops them both, and it's a three-point game.
That last free throw was critical. Their only choice now is to go for the three to tie.
One more round of applause for your performer.
Outside, MP on the wing, Diaz, Erickson covering, and here's MP from the arc, he's off from three, and an intentional foul there, stops the clock.
Yeah, you can't let him hold the ball and just milk those seconds.
No, and you've got to foul, it's going to come down to free throws.
Pressure situation.
So he gets them both, and it's a five-point game.
Now that's how you close a game out, those free throws will bury him for sure.
Out of bounds, it'll be hustle ball.
That wasn't a steal.
And here's Jackson. And now we've got the intentional foul.
That's his first personal foul.
Good on the first. And that increases their lead to six. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. And it's a 7-point ball game. Hey there, basketball fans. We've got another G League clash coming your way. In this game, we'll see the Memphis Hustle against Team Ignite. I'm Blake Suniga, and with me today are Brian Banifatemi and Tim Swartz, and it looks like it's going to be a fun one.
The excitement in this arena is palpable. You get a strong sense for how much energy these fans are going to bring to this game.
These fans love their team, and they take pride in being heard. Most importantly, they really want to be a source of inspiration for this team.
MP outside. Fires for three. Memphis grabs the miss.
Yeah, the G League hit hard by the pandemic, along with really every other league in the world, every sport. They had to cancel the end of the 2020 season. They played a shortened season in 2021 in a bubble in Orlando.
Now here's Early. Here's Barea. 4 on the clock. Up top, Erickson. Shoots over Diaz. And not gonna go. He misses his first attempt of the night. And with the G League, they ended up with a bubble season, and that made for some intense basketball.
And I feel like that was the right choice for the G League, because teams were still able to develop their youth, and it was done in a safe and controlled environment.
Now here's Erickson. Rejected by MP.
Textbook defense from MP. That's just gotta bump him up whenever he's able to come up with blocks.
It's his first trip to the line. And you'd have to think it's exciting for the Hustle, being an affiliate of the Grizzlies, a young and up-and-coming team.
Absolutely. That creates a great energy for everybody involved. And, you know, all these guys are dreaming of moving up, joining the Grizz for their next playoff run.
And you look at how the G League is attracting top high school talent now. What do you think that'll do to the college game?
It could be good in that we'll probably see fewer one-and-dones. Universities can now focus on players who might be there for a while, and that could help continuity, which is a big plus.
And Jackson gets it to go.
The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very well done.
Down low. And MP gets it to go.
A good aggressive play by Antin, taking it up inside and refusing to back off because of the contact.
Priapa outside. Outside Berea. There's the triple. The shot's good. Priapa making the play.
He's not going to miss these very often, even from deep. The D has to come closer and close him down.
Pass to MP. Palmer with it. MP. MP can't get that one to fall.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Lucky he was off.
I hope that was a mistake by the D, because if that's how they plan to guard him, they're going to have some problems.
First look here at the former college standout MP. Decided to make the move to the G League for this year.
And for his development, it makes sense. Had a good run in college and the tournament, so I'm interested to see how he fares in the G League.
Now here is Berea. The offensive rebound. Priapa outside.
Another three for Memphis.
It's so hard to contain him. He gets it done however he has to do it.
Pass to Palmer. But they recover it. Back to MP. Jacks up a three. It's hauled in by Jackson. The hustle leading. To the middle. And slam dunk by Jackson.
Oh, maestro. He is so good at making those lead passes.
Outside Palmer. Bayless. MP outside. Trains the three-pointer.
Hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter. Offensively, at least.
Memphis calls timeout.
He could be just trying to get a break in action to clear their heads. They've gone ice cold, and it wouldn't be a bad idea to give them a quick break.
Yeah, they needed the timeout here. Anything to try to get them to get all the missed shots we've been seeing.
Maybe refocus a bit.
Here's a good one. Left wing for three. That's no good. This is his first shot of the night.
And for many of these players, this is the first time they're getting a taste of professional ball.
And when ball is your job, as you said, Brian, if you get good in a hurry, there will be a lot to learn from any first-time G Leaguers. It's a bit of a trial by fire.
And out of bounds, the hustle will take it. Berea with the ball. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And again, no good by Memphis. And here's Palmer. MP outside. Thomas, he's covered by Bonner. Outside Palmer. Pass to MP. Out to the wing. With one on the clock. So it's a tie game as we end the first. And don't go away, as we'll be back. Now that the first quarter is finished, what are your thoughts on both teams making substitutions here?
Substitution.
Outside Bautista. Outside Peterson. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter of basketball. MP, covered by Jackson.
2 minutes remaining.
And you look at Team Ignite, it's a great way to get experience and prepare for the NBA draft.
You can't overlook how paramount a professional type of environment, professional development is. You know, on this team, the prospects can eat and sleep basketball 24/7. It's the only thing on the menu. You can't get that anywhere else.
Here's MP for three. It's good. The assist that time
from
AI.
Nice hit from the power forward. AI wants to hit his guys in their spots. Textbook pass.
Now here's Erickson. He's guarded closely. Just five to shoot. Goodbye, Memphis.
offensively speaking.
Pass to MP. Back to Peterson. Bayless. MP outside. And another three for Team Ignite.
Triples keep on falling, guys. Three in a row now.
These defenders can't stay so soft on the perimeter.
They really want to find that igniter here.
That's right. Their offense is ground to a standstill.
Maybe you need to suit up, Tim. They need a spark. Count
it. 2 points, Philip Early.
Now here's AI. He's got 11. And the big names for Team Ignite are part of the one-year program. They get compensated well as they prepare for the NBA draft.
The team serves as a professional training center for elite talent. Just another fantastic path to the NBA.
Two on the clock. Bautista, unable to get that one to go. Erickson with some nice defense there. Soft touch off the glass.
Brooke Erickson.
Screen by MP. AI outside. Here's MP for three, and no good. That's trying to get that one. Half. A dominating first half of play, and 42. So far it hasn't been close. Team Ignite ahead, 25. Leading by 17. Yeah. And we've got more in store for you right after this. And now that we're halfway through this one, give me a breakdown of what you're seeing from MP.
I'd say if he were auditioning for a stretch five role in the NBA, he nailed it. Really proving his ability to do damage beyond the arc.
Yeah, a lot of threes on a great percentage. That's a good skill for a modern big man to have. You gotta be able to shoot it from deep.
And stolen by Kriappa. To the paint. Here's Jackson. The dunk and the foul. A powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. MP picks one up. And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
And look at this Team Ignite roster. It is special. A ton of talent jumping off the roster sheet.
They'll need to fuse it all together over the course of the season, but this is one of the most talented Team Ignite rosters we've seen. A lot can happen over the course of the year.
And the shot's good by Diaz.
Well, this is why you can't give Diaz any space to shoot. He's ready to fire as soon as he gets it.
Pass to Kriappa. Over AI, and it's Memphis scoring again.
Aaron Kriappa.
Superb assist. He played the role of maestro on that one.
Now here's AI. He's guarded by Early. MP, it's good.
That's a dozen straight points coming out the threes.
Yeah, they're having free reign from beyond the arc. The defense is, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it, non-existent.
Three Early. Memphis the rebound. Here's Jackson. And slam dunk by Jackson.
Isn't it great to see a player who worked so hard on the glass at both ends?
And that's what he's built his reputation on. Grinding away 100% effort at all times.
That's the way he plays.
And all that effort pays off. I mean, how many of those spectacular putback jams do we see from this guy?
Shot clock at six. Buries it from three-point range. And here we are kicking off the G League season. A lot of games to be played.
Well, the traditional G League schedule, 50 games. Not as many as the NBA, but it's still a grind. For many of these players, it'll be more games than they've ever played before.
Here's Kriappa. No good off the back of the rim. To the inside. Here's AI. He falls for the sixth time in seven tries. This contest. That's an 86% accuracy mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your dance squad.
One more round of applause for your
now Berea. He's got five.
Team Ignite, Jeffrey Thomas, Manuel Lawson.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Unloads from 13 feet. That one, no good. And it's Team Ignite the other way. Thomas, he's guarded by Early. MP, no good.
And their first miss of the second half. They come out strong.
Early with the ball. And Thomas picks him up defensively. Here's Grieba. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact. It's on Diaz.
For your performers.
Three-pointer. Team Ignite with the rebound. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. Outside Palmer. On the wing, Diaz. MP outside. Outside Diaz. MP on the wing. Screen by MP. MP on the wing. The shot is good. Diaz making the play.
Three triples in the first half, three in the second. They sure add up.
Back to Erickson. Outside for Kriapa.
On the triple.
Well, he for one hasn't let them down, but a few other guys need to pick up the pace.
AI with it. Pass to MP. Now Diaz. Screen by MP. Here's the three. It's hauled in by Jackson.
And guys, this is so exciting. The start of the G League season. Always fun to see new faces and talent coming into the league.
And while that's true for all teams in the G League, it's especially true for a group like Team Ignite. We could be seeing the start of not only a future NBA player, but a future franchise cornerstone tonight. He shot a very good percentage today, and they've needed it.
Pass to MP. Bayless outside. And stolen by Kriapa. Outside Erickson. Jackson. Out to Berea. The three. It's rebounded by Team Ignite. Now here's MP. It's not going to go for him. Kriapa drives in. It's Kriapa with the jam.
The one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's his hand doing the slam.
Man, he is smooth as silk, even on the power finish.
He's so pretty.
That's part of what makes it unique, that combination of the P&P, power and polish.
Here's Palmer, and he banks in the layup.
Yeah, that's just a clever drive by Edwin Palmer. He spots an opening and cuts to a shot.
And the speed of the professional game, something incoming players always talk about.
It's not as fast as the NBA, but it's a world apart from college. It'll take some getting used to for many first-year G Leaguers.
AI, covered by Jackson.
2 minutes remaining.
Here's MP for three. That shot off the mark. Pass to Kriapa. And here's Early.
Rejected by AI.
Don't try AI. This is his biggest strength, swatting shots, and this skill, it could carry him to get a spot in the NBA.
Now here's Palmer, defended by Kriapa. Back to Bayless. MP, outside Diaz. Pass to MP.
Launches a three. Rebound by the hustle.
As well as he shot in the last quarter, it's been another story in this one. He just can't get anything to fall for him.
Outside Berea. Early a screen.
Let's it go from deep.
That one doesn't go either for Early.
He's having all sorts of problems with the shot.
The way he's shooting the ball right now, yeah, the words ice and cold come to mind.
Outside Diaz. Pass to MP.
Launches it.
And it's
Diaz with the three.
And that caps off what's been a phenomenal showing for them.
Yeah, and Tim, I'd like a piece of that cake if I could have it.
What type of cake? And that one's good early.
Those are teammates who clearly know each other's moves very well.
Shot clock and game clock, 1 second differential. Here's MP for three. Priapo with the rebound. Pass to Barea. Here's Jackson. Makes it off the glass.
Found the soft spot in the D right there.
And here's MP. From deep 3-point range.
That's the end of the game.